clear from that Orianna under towers. Lulu is going to do great at holding off waves, but no threat to him. Now, with Nip returning, oh, they've got tabs.
Tabs actually taking a lot of damage back there on that front. And you see, though, the power of Thresh with the flay, with the hook that can come out afterwards, if he times it right, can even stop Leona going in the first place. And there's the hook onto Enraten. No one really ready for it, though. Tabs taking a while to reply, but he flashes in. And there is the flash we were talking about.
Bottom lane. Shook's coming to party as well, they've got Nip.
Oh, Nip out of position here, that's three men onto him. Shook's gonna have to get involved, and there he is, moving in with the slow, but Svenska and flashes over. Enraten goes low in this one. Svenska, though, is gonna be the easier target. Shook gonna pick up that one. Can they get down Enraten as well? There's a lot of damage coming in. Tab's not quite got the abilities to make it work for them, but that will end with a one for one.
Very just teleports top lane, so he'll have a shorter cooldown, but now there's an engage. Jezzes is caught a little bit by Shook.
Slowed nicely, actually will flash away from this one, and Svenskeren comes across as well, but down in the bottom lane, it's all kicking off again. There is the calling coming out. Candy Panda won't get knocked down from that one. Enraten actually tanking up most of the blue buff vision for a second, regain it back as Svenskeren is going to land the cocoon. Shockwave comes down right on top of him, and Shock will fall here as he tried to...
Members of Alliance feeling very confident. Enraten is going to look for a fight, he's going in.
Oh, the box coming down, the hook catching onto Candy Panda, and this is bad news for Candy Panda. Trying to get away from it, he won't know it. Tabs that picks up that kill, and Tabs now scary again at 2-0-1.
Lucian, who is already a strong early to mid game champion. Oh. Wicked wants Freddy.
Wicked wants Freddy. He's going to get stunned under the tower though, but he flashes in there. Freddy going to go down. Wicked will die as well. One more turret hit will do that. One for one in the top lane.
Trading one for one, but that is a Shyvana with a Sunfire cape against only the Bilgewater Cutlass. So not a bad trade, considering there's not a lot of tanky stats for Jax to work with over and above his passives. But Svenskeren now wants Tabs and Nif. Can SK get revenge?
Who are they going to go for? Nif actually wants a target, but he flashed underneath the tower. Svenskeren taking a lot of aggro as the calling comes out. He will just rappel away from it. But aggression from Tabs gets himself the one kill. Froggen's actually headed down from this bottom lane, from the mid lane as well. Not sure that they've got the damage here. Enraten extremely low from it. But can they get in position? Tabs still trying his best as he goes back in here. Surely this means Enraten's dead. But Tabs will surely pay the price as well. He does go down. Finally, the shutdown comes in from Jezzes. Station of Nif because of the ward that was placed a little earlier on. Either way, four people beats two people, and SK have to back away from that tower. Actually, they may have to back away from the inner tower.
I think they can get down. Shook's gone in.
He has gone in. There's a wild growth coming down, and they kill off Jezzes. Repel's going to get you nowhere, I'm afraid. It's a double kill for Tabs. After being taken down earlier on in the bottom lane, he comes back up with another ward. However, that might find him a rat as well. No, Tabs is there, and he's... pure presence there forcing away. However, the spider's coming in now as well. Nif gonna get locked up, but Jezzes also being fought in the middle. And by fought, I mean destroyed. Froggen will get that kill. And look at this, they've turned it around in the bottom side as well. Enraten now super low. Colin with the lantern taken. That's a good solar flare. But will he get them away? No! The Q at max range from Shook connects. Look at the timing there for Dragon as well.
Froggen is controlling the mid lane wave, preventing backup from coming in, and this is going to be a dead Jax.
Didn't really need to tank it there, Wicked, as Freddy's going to get a stun off, but he doesn't catch Tabs. There is the kickback, and in the end, an easy kill for Alliance. They took a fair bit of damage, but...
He's doing the best he could to delay the minion wave, and he's not going to defend the tower. I don't think. One more hit.
Oh, wow.
Wow, they've caught Froggen.
They've caught Froggen now, but there's the wild growth coming in. They're throwing everything at Froggen here. The shockwave goes in as well. And yes, they're going to take down...
What?
Froggen? Are they going to take down Froggen? He's running away from it. The shield on him. Svenskeren's going to try to dive. Froggen is turning around. Doesn't get the kill there on Svenskeren. So, so very close, though. But in the meantime, the inner turret in the top lane was taken away, and now Wicked coming across the side. That's a brilliant rappel. They managed to lock him up with the rest, and Wicked giving a kill up there for nothing.
Bitten off a little more than he could chew, but they were a brute forcing their way into this one. The Culling used just for poke to try and force SK back. They've got Sven!
Hawk onto Svenska, and they just about bring him into box range as Freddy comes forward. Two-man shockwave. Stun comes in as a wild growth. Isn't going to be enough to save Froggen, but the kill's coming back as well here. For Alliance, no, they didn't. They didn't get down Enraten. He was able to flash away, and that is not a bad defense whatsoever. Two men taken. Svenskeren, is he going to pull through? Yes, he is, but it's taken already by SK Gaming.
Like Freddy's build, he still has not gone tank. He's going for a Trinity Force as a second item. Tabs should kill Candy.
Oh, this is going to be close, I think, with a Blade of the Rune King coming through, and
heal.
It will be Candy Panda taken. That. That summoner heal making it if they can pile their entire combo together. And SK can...
Water been denied by SK. So, blue buff gets taken away. Sven's in trouble. Alliance are committing to this fight. Look for the solar flare.
He's going to come down. There's a shockwave onto Shook and Frog, and it didn't really do much damage. Will hold them back. The solar flare used. Svenskun's dead. Jezus is dead. This is going badly for SK Gaming. Freddy wasn't even there. He was down on the bottom side and has not teleported up there just yet. He got himself the tower. Now will teleport in, but now it's about rescuing Baron.
This is a 3v5. And Rage has gone in.
He's gone in. Froggen's gone. Very, very low. Can he finish him off? Yes, he can. It's Candy Panda that gets that. He's going untamed at the back, but finally, they will spot him. Freddy doing a lot of damage as well. Candy Panda in the end gets the kill onto Nip. Three men left alive for an Svenskun's health gone. Not really what they would have been hoping for with that one, but it looks like they're going to go for it. Solar flare slow in a couple at the back, but it's Nip that's been focused down. The rat attack tack coming through from Candy Panda, and now Wicked's going to be the focus. Cocoon lands. Will that be the end of him? Stun up from Freddy. Wicked does get his ulti off, and there is Wild Growth. Not enough to keep him alive, though. SK have got five men still up, and they're going to go down
to the engage. So tower is secured for SK. It looks like they've set their sights on the inhibitor. There's a lot of beefiness, and they do have those spiderlings to tank up.
Alliance are going to go for the sneaky Baron.
They need to get more damage on you and quicker. A third of it's been lost. I think SK, I think they're going to be too late. I don't think they can make it. Alliance, they lose the fight. They lose two towers, but they grab themselves Baron. We are in for a hell of a game.
36 minutes into this one, and there we see it again, how much damage Wicked actually is going to be taken. They've gone on towards Orianna. Wild Growth comes onto Shook, but they may have thrown too much in there too early. Wicked going to go low. So let's go from the side, and there is a shockwave coming out. Wicked able to stay alive from this one, and Svenskun will have to rappel away from the minions.
Since we're winning, SK's pulled it back, and Candy Panda is so scary, he gets played away.
Played away, Box actually going down. Wicked's going to dive right in there, trying to get onto Candy Panda. They hug Freddy as well, but this is a mess. This is a very, very messy fight. Shook in the middle of them, going to try and kick Candy Panda back. Does do that. They're going to take him down. The AD carry's dead. Elise will repel. Jezus is burning. Froggen gets that one, and that is two men down. The mid laner, the AD carry, and now the jungler down here for SK Gaming. Alliance will surely want to win the game here.
They've got
into the fountain as if to say, let's not give up any more points in this one, and it will be Alliance that break through after 41 minutes. A hard-fought match for them, but they take the victory over SK and go top of the European LCS.
Far good performance considering how much pressure they were under in that mid-game.
You have to wonder though about that last move, if you can really call it a move at the end there. It was all...